his principal legacy, the thing that he will be remembered for, is restoring the monarchy. So if you go back to the start of his reign in 1946, it's the end of the Second World War. You have Thailand in terrible condition and economically ravaged, you know, at a very low point in its history. Now, but you go from the Second World War, when King Bhumibol was a symbol, but you go from the end of the Second World War to the time of his death. Thailand is a big, important, second largest economy in ASEAN in this part of the world, and a modernizing state. So it's a huge change, and it's very difficult to pick out one thing on that continuum. But the monarchy was restored. The Thais have had kings right back to Sukhothai, so you're talking 800 years. So kings are something that are established. If you look at what Thais think about their kings, they don't judge them individually. And King Bhumibol had this very long reign. He had a very consistent set of policies that he pursued. He accumulated what the Thais call barami, so that he had this, these credits, if you like. If you read articles in the foreign media, they always say the revered King Bhumibol. They always use that term, and it's not a cliche. If you talk about the majority of Thais, the overwhelming majority of Thais, that is the way they feel. You know, from an outside point of view, that it should be recognised that he was held in very high esteem.